Hi, it's Robin, and I've got a bit of a show and tell video for you here today. What I want to talk about is non-verbal prayer, and what else would you call it? I would call it prophetic prayer. I told my wife about this idea. She said she would call it symbolic prayer. She said similar to in the Catholic Church where they would, like after a prayer, they light a candle, and just as a symbol, like you're not finished your prayer. Your prayer is always going up to the Father. So what's an example? This is just thinking outside the box, right? Different non-traditional ways of praying. So what did I do? So the first, I've done this a couple times over the last couple months. So I booked my vacation around March or whatever, and booked for the last week of May was one of them. And my wife really wanted to get away, but we didn't know where we were going. So one day, last fall, we had this awesome vacation in South Carolina, and I bought some really nice clothes. This is one of the shirts I bought, but this shirt, I love it. So I was wearing the shirt around just as a reminder to God, hey, I've got vacation booked, and you've been so good to us with vacations in the past, and we're just looking to go away. And we just had a great week in Cocoa, Cuba, my wife and I. And it was just so relaxing, so nice, and like God is just so good. So what else have I been doing? Well, I had this t-shirt that my son gave me. Oh, more show and tell stuff falling. This is a Rush t-shirt, one of their best albums. It's Moving Pictures. And my son gave that to me as a late birthday gift. So the last time I went to a D-Hop Durham House of Prayer, the first song they did was Holy and Anointed One. And the Holy Spirit's got me kind of leaning. I can't do it in this chair, the back's too high, but I'm kind of leaning back like that towards the Lord with my chest out. And I'm wearing the shirt that my son gave me. And it's just, I'm thinking this is great. Like, my son is before the Lord. And so it reminds me of this album that I have. It's by Joe Weber, and it's called Make My Life a Prayer. So I've been listening to that a lot today before I've done this video. You can find, she's got a website, just make sure you spell Weber right with only one B. And non-traditional ways of praying. Well, let's start again. So you can't do that. So I have one more situation to tell you about, which I can't tell you. My wife reminded me it's confidential because it involves people not in our family. It involves other people too. But just symbolically, prophetically, what I did this weekend is I bought some Chinese beer. This is, you don't say it like it's spelled, it's Tsingtao. And I bought a six pack of that, and that's my prophetic prayer this weekend.